ओके लिसन डियर स्टूडेंट्स, 44 क्वेश्चन। द रेट कॉन्स्टेंट इज न्यूमेरिकली फॉर सेम, मीन्स के इज सेम, सी एस्पेशली फॉर केमिस्ट्री ऑब्जेक्टिव नीट एंड जेई एग्जामिनेशन, we have to read the question neatly, we have to understand the question, then we can solve very easily. The rate constant k is same for three reactions, first order and second order and third order reactions, same for n = 1, n = 2, and n = 3. First n means order, n, okay, is same for first, second and third order reactions respectively. Which of the following statement is correct, they are asked. See, for this A is converted into P, products. For first order reaction, if n is equals to 1, then the rate is equals to K into concentration of A. Okay, so this rate we are considered as R1. For this, rate is equals to k into concentration of A. If n is equals to 2, means order n is equals to 2, then its rate R2 is equals to k into concentration of A whole square. And order n is equals to 3, the rate is equals to k into A cube, because n is equals to 3. This is first order, second order and third order rate expression just written now. Now let's see that which of the following statement is correct. If concentration of first statement or first option, let's check, concentration of A is equals to 1, means 1 square value 1 and 1 cube value is also 1. Therefore, then R1 is equals to R2 is equals to R3. It's very clear because K is same value for all. Next, the second one, let it, you have to check, if concentration of A is less than 1, concentration of A is less than 1 means concentration of A is decreasing, means maybe in fractional values, less than 1 means that is maybe 0.1 or 0.2, like fractional values, then automatically what happens, ma'am? A square value, A, concentration of A is more than concentration of A square and then concentration of A cube. It's very clear because decimal values, fractional values increases, its power value will be decreases. Means 1 is more value than 0.01, like 0.05, like some values. That's why in this case, concentration of A is more than A square and then A cube. When concentration of A is less than 1, then this case R1 is more than R2 and then R3. So the second statement is also correct. Next, the third statement, if concentration of A is more than 1, more than 1 means the values, concentration of A is 2, 3, 4, 5, like, means more than 1, means the positive integers, then concentration of A less than A square and then A cube. Automatically, third order reaction rate is more than second order and then first order. R3 is more. So the third statement is also correct. So the answer is all of this correct. Okay, fourth option is correct. Understood? It's very easy, ma'am. Just we have to keep it in your mind, K is constant, rate constant. K means rate constant. For first order, second order and third order is same. And here the reactant is A. So for first order expression, rate expression K is R is equals to R1 is equal to K A. R2 is equal to K A square. R3 is equal to K A cube. Now you have to check that three conditions. If concentration of A is equal to 1, then first order, second order, and third order rate is equal to same. If concentration of A is decreases, then that the rate will be decreases. So least rate is present in third order, and then second order, and then first order. So first order rate is more than second order, and then third order when the concentration of A is decreases. If concentration of A is increasing, then the A cube value is more. That's why R3 is more than R2 and then R1. Okay. Next, let's go for next question 45. See, this 45 question also very easy. See, 99% of first order reaction is completed in 2.303 minutes. Means T is equals to 2.303 minutes. What is the rate constant and half life of this reaction? See, for first order reaction, for first order reaction, rate constant K formula is equals to 2.303 by T into log A by A minus X. A means initial concentration. A minus X means final concentration of reactant left in a chemical reaction. See, then the K is equals to 2.303 by time 2.303 minutes. At that time, how much percentage of reaction is completed? 99% of reaction is completed means initially it is 100%. Then A 100 minus 99% of reactant is converted into product. X means the amount of product or the amount of reactant decomposed. Okay, 100 minus 99 means 1. Log 100 is equal to 2. Is nothing but this will cancel, then is equal to log 100. Log 100 is nothing but 2 log 10. 2 log 10 is nothing but 2, because log 10 is equal to 1. Okay, so the K is equals to 2 minute inverse, because the units are in minute inverse. Now half-life period for zero order reactions. We know that T half is equals to 0.693 by K. Then K value is 2. Then 0.693 by 2 is equal to 0.693 by 2 is equals to 0.3465 minutes. 65 minutes. So the answer is second option. The answer is a second option. Already this kind of questions we did earlier also. Okay, students, let's go for next question. For the first order reaction, A is converted into products. The concentration of A changes from 0.1 to 0.025 molar in 40 minutes. The rate of the reaction when the concentration of A is equal to 0.01. See, the change in the concentration with respect to time, 40 minutes they gave. Now we have to find out the rate of reaction at 0.01 molar concentration. We need to find out for this case. Rate constant. Okay. So rate constant we need to find out. See, for first order reaction, rate constant K is equals to 2.303 by T into log A by A minus X. Log A by A minus X. See here, A is converted into products. A is converted into product. Initial concentration is equal to 0.1, and final concentration, that is equal to A, and final concentration A minus X is equal to 0.025. Now just to substitute, then time is equal to 40 minutes. Just to substitute, then K value will comes. By using that K value, we have to find out the rate of first order reaction at 0.01 molar concentration. We need to find out C 2.303 by T, 40 into log 0.1 by 0.025. 0.1 by 0.025. Then is equal to how many times? It is approximately is equal to 4 times. Log 4 value is 0.6. Then 2.303 by 40 into log 4. Log 4 is nothing but 2 log 2. Log 2 value is 0.3010, is approximately 0.3, then is equal to 0.6. Then 2.303 by 40 into 0.6. On simplification, we'll get K value 0.0345 minute inverse. 345 minute inverse. Now we have to find the rate of reaction at 0.01 molar. Okay, 0.01 molar concentration of A is equals to rate formula is equals to K into concentration of A. Then K value we know that, concentration of A also we know that, 0.0345 into concentration of A 0.01. Then on multiplication we'll get 3.45 into 0.01 is nothing but 10 to the power of minus 2. This is 10 to the power of minus 2. Then total 10 to the power of minus 4 molar, means mole per liter minute inverse. Mole per liter minute inverse. So the answer is 3.45 into 10 to the power of minus 4 is approximately 3.47 into 10 to the power of minus 4, means first option is correct. Okay, let's see the next question. Next question, 47. The reaction 2A is converted to B is first order reaction. First order in A with rate constant they gave. K value they gave. How long will time it will takes nearly, the concentration of A is decreased from 0.08 to 0.28. Means initial concentration and final concentration they gave. So this we can solve. 2A is converted into B. Okay, at initial concentration A is equals to 0.88 molar, and final concentration A minus X is equal to 0.22 molar. Okay, and time we have to find out. Time T we need to find out for changing these concentrations. How much time is required? How much time is required? And order of this reaction is equal to 1. N is equal to 1 means it is first order reaction. It is a first order reaction. How long time it will take? And rate constant also they give. K is equal to 2.8 into 10 to the power of minus 2 second inverse. Okay, so then the required formula is equal to K is equal to 2.303 by T into log A by A minus X. So all numericals we know that except time. Then we have to find out the time, T value. T value will comes in seconds. Then T is equal to 2.303 by k into log a by a minus x. Okay, then 2.303 by k value, how much they gave? 2.8 into 10 to the power of minus 2 into log a, mean 0.88 by a minus x is 0.22. It will cancel how many times, ma? 4 times it will cancel. Means it is nothing but log 4. Log 4 value is 2.03 by 2.8 into 10 to the power of minus 2 into log 4 value is 0.6. On simplification, we'll get the time is 2.03 into 0.6 by 2.8 into 10 square. This is on simplification, we'll get approximately 0.5 into 10 square is nothing but 50 seconds. 50 seconds is enough for changing the concentration of A from 0.88 molar to 0.22 molar under first order reaction. So the answer is third option. Okay, let's see 48th question. Okay, clear students? 48. For first order reaction, half-life is equal to half-life of 150 seconds. The time taken for the concentration of the reactant falls from 1 by 10 molar to 1 by 100 molar. It will be half-life they gave. According to the half-life, K value we need to find out by using, again, 47 model question only. See, T half means for first order reaction, T half is equals to 150 seconds. Very clear. Now K is equals to 0.693 by T half is equals to 0.693 by 150. This is on simplification, we'll get approximately 0.00462 second inverse is nothing but 4.62 into 10 to the power of minus 3 second inverse. So K we know that. Now what we have to find out? Time we need to find out. So K is equals to 2.303 by T into log A by A minus X. See, in this question, A is equal to initial concentration is equal to 1 by 10m and A minus X is equal to final concentration is equal to 1 by 100m. Okay, then T value we have to find out. The T is equal to 2.303 by K into log A by A minus X. Okay, is equals to 2.303 by K value. Already we are find out 4.62 into 10 to the power of minus 3 into log A value is 1 by 10 and A minus X value is 1 by 100. This 1 by 10 whole by 1 by 100 is nothing but 100 by 10 is nothing but 10. So is nothing but 2.303 by 4.62 into 10 to the power of minus 3 into log 10. On simplification, this will get 10. Then log 10 value is nothing but 1. Log 10 is equals to 1. Then this is on simplification, 2.303 by 4.62 into 10 to the power of minus 3. On simplification, we'll get 2.303 by 4.62 into 10 cube. 10 cube is nothing but 1000. Is approximately how many times it will cancel? 1 and 2 times 1 by 2 is nothing but 0.5 into 1000 is nothing but 500 seconds. Okay. See, under first order reaction, the concentration of reactant changed from 1 by 10 molar to 1 by 100 molar. How much time is required? 500 seconds is required. Sometimes instead of 500 seconds, that value they are giving in minutes. So seconds, how to convert it into minutes? So the seconds, do you want to convert into minutes? Means divided by 60. Then we'll get in minutes. Okay, so in this case, units are very, very important. Okay, let's see next. 49 question. In a first order reaction, 50 minutes time is taken for the completion of T93.75% of a reaction. Half life of the reaction they're asked. See, in first order reaction, T93.75% is completed. Okay, for example, 49th question. In first order reaction, T half, half life period is independent. Of initial concentration. Initial concentration of reactant. It's very clear. Now let's see regarding that, generally we can follow that. We have one relation also. T93.75% is equal to 4 T halves. Means it is 4 times more than T50%. According to that, T50% we can calculate. Otherwise, theoretically, for example, reactant initially concentration is 100%. Okay. Then half life, first T half is equal, it becomes 50%. Second T half, it becomes 25%. Then the third T off, it becomes 12.5%. Then another half life T off is equals to 6.25%. Okay. Clear. Now it is 1, 2, 3, 4. If you are observed that this 100% reactant concentration, percentage of reactant is equal to 100 is converted into 6.25%. Means 100 minus 6.25 is equal to 93.75% of reactant converted into product. Therefore, it requires how much time? T93.75% of reactant converted into product, or T93.75% of reactant decomposed into product, it requires how much time? 1, 2, 3, 4. 4 T offs are required. 1, 2, 3, 4. Means 4 T offs. This is relation. This relation, otherwise we have to remember this relation directly. Okay, now T half is equal to T93.75% for completion of the reaction required time by 4. Then how much time they gave? 50 minutes they gave. 50 by 4 is equal to 54 is equal to how much time? 12.5 minutes. Okay, students. So this is the way for solving this kind of questions. It's very easy and important also, and very very important also. Okay, let's see next 50th question. The 50th question, in 69.3 minutes, first order reaction is 50% completed, means half life. How much reactants are left after 161 minutes? How much reactant is left after 161 minutes? See, in this question, 50th question, T half is equal to 0.693 by K. Okay, students. Now, T half is equal to 69.3 minutes they gave, then K is equal to 0.693 by T half is equal to 0.693 by K. T half is equal to how much, ma? 69.3. Is equal to 10 to the power of minus 2 minute inverse. Okay, now how much reactant are left after 161 means A minus X value we need to find out. Okay, then K is equal to, we need to find out A minus X or K is equals to 2.303 by T into log A by A minus X. A minus X means the amount of reactant left in the reaction. Okay, now T is equals to 10 to the power of minus 2 is equals to 2.303 by 161 into log A by A minus X. Sorry, if A is equal to 100%, then A minus X percentage we need to calculate. A is equal to 100%, then 10 to the power of minus 2 is equal to 2.303 by 161 into log 100 by A minus X. Then log 100 by A minus X is equal to 161 into 10 to the power of minus 2 by 2.303. On simplification, this value will get 0.699 is nothing but 0.7. See, log 100 by A minus X is equal to 0.7. This logarithm we need to remove means 10 to the power is nothing but anti-log of 0.7. is nothing but 100 by A minus X is equal to 10 to the power of 0.7. 10 to the power of 0.7 is equal to 5. Then 100 by A minus X is equal to 5. Then on simplification, X will get 20%. Sorry, A minus X value will get 20%. Then A minus X is equal to 100 by 5 is equal to 20%. So how much percentage of reactant is left? 20% of reactant left after 161 minutes means 80% reaction completed. 80% reaction is completed. Okay. See, the answer is third option. Okay. Let's see Next question, 51, matching. For first order reactions all are photo radioactive reactions. Zero order reactions are photochemical reactions. Okay, trimolecular reaction means molecularity is 3. Here, what is the molecularity? 2CO plus O2 is molecularity is 3. See, this third one is D. Automatically off life period, fourth one is A. So like answer we have to choose. First one is C, send one is B, two is C. One is B, two is C, and three is D. And four is A, means second option is correct. Second option is correct. Okay, dear students, let's see 52. Question. It's very easy question and important also. A plus B is converted into C plus D. Then delta H value they give. See, the activation energy of forward reaction is 85. Then the activation energy of backward reaction they ask. See, in this case, delta H is equals to activation energy symbol is EA of forward reaction minus EA of backward reaction. Okay, now the delta H value is 20 kilojoules they gave. Then activation energy of forward reaction is 85 minus activation energy of backward reaction we need to find out. Then this value is coming to this side, this is coming to then it becomes plus. Then activation energy of backward reaction is equal to 85 plus 20. Okay, is equal to 105 kilojoules. See here the formula is very very important. Active delta H change in enthalpy is equal to activation energy of forward reaction minus activation energy of backward reaction. Okay, let's see next. Level 3. The level 3 first question, let's see, it's very easy. First write the given reaction. X moles of A plus Y moles of B is converted into Z moles of C. For this rate expression, our average rate is equals to minus 1 by X into change in the concentration of A with respect to time is equals to minus 1 by Y is equals to change in the concentration of B with respect to time is equals to 1 by Z into change in the concentration of C by dt. Okay, now this we have to compare in the above equation. This is equal to minus dA by dt is equals to minus dB by dt is equal to 1.5 is nothing but 3 by 2 dc by dt. Okay, now we have to find out x, y, z values. Okay, let's see. From this, here 2 is present, then all equations we have to multiply with 3. 2, then minus 2 dA by dt is equals to minus 2 dB by dt is equals to 3 by dc by dt. Now here 1 by x is equal to 2, then x is equal to 1 by 2 Sorry. Now, just wait. Okay, listen dear students, now this value have to divide by all values with 1 by 3, then minus 1 by 3 into dA by dt is equals to minus 1 by 3.